Is my voice is audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Board is also clear, no?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Keep the heading as transistor biasing and thermal stabilization. Okay then, so let us start the class. Okay, so the today's topic is transistor biasing and thermal stabilization. Okay, before we go ahead, okay, our actual objective is to build an amplifier. Okay, our actual objective is to build an amplifier. Okay, our actual objective is to build an amplifier. So how do I build an amplifier? Okay, the question is, how do I build an amplifier, right? So before we look at the answer, that how do I build an amplifier, okay, so let me give you a quick review of what are all the essential things for us, okay, for a better understanding of this particular course. Okay, so one point is, these things maybe you might have already noted down in your notebook. So just verify that whether you have noted down or not. If you have noted down, no need to note down again. Okay. If you have noted down, no need to note down again. Okay. So this is my NPN transistor. So how I'll be representing my symbol is such that my current is always flowing from top to the bottom. Okay, my current is always flowing from top to the bottom. Okay, my current is always flowing from top to the bottom. Okay, my collector current is this, my base current, emitter current. You know that I is equal to IB plus IC is always holding good. Okay, I is equal to IB plus IC is always holding good. Current entering is equal to current leaving. Okay, so I am trying to draw the diagram or symbol of my transistor in such a way that current always flows from top to the bottom. So this is my collector current, this is my base current, emitter current. Okay, and this equation is always holding good, right? Okay, if it is a PNP transistor, okay, if it is a PNP transistor, if it is a PNP transistor, then also I am going to make sure that the current is always flowing from top to the bottom. Okay, so this time this is my emitter current, this is my base current, this is my collector current. Again I can write that my I is equal to IB plus IC. Again I have drawn my symbol in such a way that current is flowing from top to the bottom. Okay, right. So there is one more thing that we need to keep in our mind is, representation of DC and AC quantities, okay, where we will be using very frequently. For example, if I am having VB like this, okay, this is representing a DC quantity. Okay, if I am having small v suffix small b, this is representing an AC quantity. Okay, this is representing an AC quantity, right? If I am writing like small suffix capital B, okay, this is nothing but your capital VBE plus small VB. Please do understand, okay, you can note it down these things. Capital B suffix BE is DC, small b suffix small BE is AC, small v suffix capital BE is what is, this is DC plus AC, okay, this is DC and this is AC. So AC plus DC is what is being represented like this, small suffix capital, all are capitals DC, all are small AC, small suffix capital AC plus DC, that is instantaneous value. Okay. And moreover, you know that VBE can be written as VB minus VE. Okay. You know that VBE is equal to VB minus VE. Okay. VBE is equal to VB minus VE. VB is always with respect to ground. Okay. VB is always with respect to ground. VE is always with respect to ground. Whereas VBE is voltage between base and the emitter. Okay. Voltage between base and the emitter. Okay.
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, VE with respect to things, sir. The VE.
V? VE with respect to ground. If the second point is not there, means it is always with respect to ground. Okay? Second point is not there, means... Yes?
VB ko ground ke kada?
Haan, VB kuda ground hai nandu. But VBE is in between base and the emitter. Okay? See, I am having my transistor like this. Okay? I am having my transistor like this. This is base, this is collector, this is emitter. Understand? VB means from here to, this is positive, okay, from here to ground, okay, from here to ground is what is VB, okay, right? VE means from here to ground is what is VE. With respect to ground is what is denoted by V. VBE means from base to the emitter, that is what is this VBE. Okay. For example, VCB. VCB is C is plus B is minus. So VCB. Okay. Between collector and the base, the voltage you are looking for. VCE between C and E. Between collector and the emitter, you are looking, that is VCE. Okay. Suppose if only VC means from the collector to the ground. Instead of taking in between collector to the emitter as VCE, if you take in between collector to ground, then you call it as VC. If I am taking from here to ground, then I call this as VC. Okay. So, anything with respect to ground. If I don't mention any reference point, it is, in other words, you are taking the voltage with respect to ground. Okay. Right. Okay. Then there is one more aspect that you have to look into is, how do I write my VCB? Okay, how do I write my VCB? Okay, look at here. VCB, I am writing it as VCE minus VBE. Please understand, okay? VCB, I am writing it as VCE minus VBE. Why? Because what is VCE? Is VC minus VE. Minus VBE is VB minus VE. So what is that? I can write VC minus VE minus VB plus VE. So when plus VE minus VE gets cancelled, what is that? I can write VC minus VB. We all know that VCB can be written as VC minus VB. But even I can write it as VCE minus VBE also. Okay. VCB can be written as VCE minus VBE, because VCB is same as VC minus VB, even if you write like this. Okay.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. So, okay then. Now, let us come to the point. How we can build the amplifier, okay? How we can build the amplifier, okay? For example, before I build, let me draw the characteristics of, okay? Characteristics of the collector current and the base emitter voltage, okay? VBE will be in millivolts, IC will be in milliampere. One point seven milliampere, 2.48 milliamps. Okay. Look at this diagram. Okay. The dependency of your IC on VBE. Okay. You all know the operation of the transistor. Okay. You all know the operation of the transistor. What is the operation of the transistor? For example, NPN. This is emitter. This is base. This is collector. Okay. You are making your emitter base junction forward biased so that current is going to flow in this direction, that is from P side to the N side, right? What carriers are going to go from P side to the N side? Electrons. Okay. See, what are the majority? Electrons are going to flow from where to where? Electrons are going to flow from N side to the P side. Holes are going to flow from P side to the N side. But in an NPN transistor, what are the majority charge carriers? Electrons. So electrons will be more in number. That means primarily the current due to this emitter base junction will be due to the electrons. Okay? Right. So these electrons will be flowing in this direction. Okay? And those electrons are being collected by this collector junction, because collector junction is being made reverse biased. Okay? What is connected to the collector junction? Collector terminal is connected to plus. Base terminal is connected to minus. This plus is going to attract all the electrons emitted by your emitter. Okay. So electrons are being collected by your collector, and these electrons is responsible for the flow of your emitter current, which is due to the electrons. Okay. So the collector current is dependent on the amount of charge carriers that are being pumped in by the emitter, and which in turn depends on the VBE of the emitter base junction. Okay. Right. So exactly like a diode current equation. Exactly like a diode current equation. I repeat again.
Forward bias.
Forward bias only. Forward bias only. Okay. So the collector current can be given as, okay. Collector current can be given as, what is this relationship? Is that not looking like a diode characteristics? My IC is always given as IS into e power VBE by VT. Of course, there is minus 1 also, I am neglecting for the time being. Okay. Actual equation of your diode current is IS into e power V by VT minus 1. I am neglecting that. Okay. Right. Because reverse saturation current is very, very small, I can neglect that. This is what is the collector current equation. Okay. This is what is the collector current equation. Okay. If this is the collector current equation, can you tell me what is emitter current equation? Emitter current is given by IC by alpha. Okay, where IC is IS into e power VBE by VT. Okay, e power VBE by VT. Right, so this is your emitter current. Just remember your collector current, that is more than enough. Okay, because you know the relation between emitter current, collector current, base current, collector current, and so on. Okay, so your IC is given by IS into e power VBE by VT. IC is equal to IS into e power VBE by VT. Okay, so your collector current is exponentially related to the emitter base voltage that you are going to apply. Okay, your collector current is exponentially related to the emitter current, emitter base voltage that we are going to apply. Okay, because it is more or less an emitter base junction, which is a diode. Okay, that is why I have written a simple diode equation itself. Okay, I have simply written a diode equation itself. Okay, so with this understanding of relation between VBE and the collector current, now let us try to build an amplifier. Okay, I know that transistor is being used to build as an amplifier. So I'll be taking my NPN transistor. Okay. This is my base. This is my collector. This is my emitter. Okay. So I'll be taking my output here. Okay. I'll be taking my output here. I'll be applying my input here. Which configuration it is? Which configuration it is?
VBE configuration, sir.
Common base.
Which configuration it is? which configuration it
Common
is?
emitter,
Common
common loop.
emitter configuration. Okay. So now let us see that whether it is going to be amplifying if I directly give the input signal to it or not. Okay. What signal I want to amplify? Maybe the signal. Okay. The signal which is getting from your mic. Okay. The signal which you are getting from your mic. This is microphone. Okay. You are speaking through your microphone, and it is having two wires, and one wire is connected here, and another wire is connected here. Okay. Whatever you are speaking through this mic, you want to get amplified with the help of your amplifier. And what type of amplifier you are using is CA amplifier. Because it is CA amplifier, you are applying your input in between base and the emitter. Let me call this as VBE. Okay. Is it AC signal or DC signal?
AC signal.
AC signal, because from the mic our voice signal is AC signal. It is being applied directly to your base and the emitter. And where I want to take my output? I want to take my output in between collector and the emitter. Okay. So what is my load actually? My load may be your loudspeaker. Okay. To what you will be giving your amplified signal? To the loudspeaker. Let it be some RL. Okay. Let it be some RL. This is where I will be taking my output voltage across RL. Okay. This is where I will be taking my output voltage across RL. Right. Okay. This is the scenario. Now let us see what is the problem in this circuit in order to use it as an amplifier. Okay. So what are the current directions? This is my collector current. Right. This is my base current. Yes or no? Current entering, current leaving. This is my emitter current. Okay. Can anyone tell me what is my output voltage is given by? Can anyone tell me what is my output voltage is given by? My output voltage is equal to, can anyone? Output voltage across RL is given by?
VCG.
Output voltage across RL is given by the current flowing through RL into RL. Okay, V is equal to IR. The current flowing through RL is, if my collector current is in this direction, what is the current that is flowing in the other direction? Minus IC. Okay, so minus IC into RL is what is my output voltage. Minus IC into RL is what is my output voltage. Is this fine? My output voltage is given as minus IC into RL is what is my output voltage. Okay, right? Yes or no?
Sir.
Okay, we will see. Is this okay so far? Have you noted down this? Please note down this quickly so that we will move ahead.
Sir, V not VCE avada?
V not VCE. Yeah, it can be. Okay. Your V naught is in between V to C is same as your voltage across your RL. Both are same.
Yes.
Okay, both are same. You call this output voltage as VCE or you call it as V naught. Both are being same. Because all the time your output may not be your VCE, I am calling it as V naught. Okay. If every time my output is VCE, then straight away I can write it as VCE itself. In this particular case, it is satisfied that my V naught is same as VC. But in practice, you will be calling it as an output. You may take output not only in between VC, you may take at any other node also. Then you have to represent it as output voltage. Okay. In this case, VCE is same as your V naught 100%. Okay, no issue. Let's look at that. This output is across RL. One end of the RL is connected to collector. Other end of the RL is connected to emitter. So 100% VCE is same as V naught. No issue. Okay. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So suppose or let IS is equal to 10 to the power of minus 16 amperes. Okay. That IS is equal to 10 to the power of minus 16 amperes. Okay. Assume that your VBE. What is my VBE is? My VBE is signal coming from your mic. Let us say that it is roughly 10 millivolts. Okay. suppose you want your gain to be, you want your gain to be 10. Okay, if you want your gain to be 10, what should be my output is? If you want your gain to be 10, what should be my output is? Gain is equal to output by input. So, output is equal to gain into input. So, gain is 10 into input is 10 millivolts. So, what is my output has to be? 100 millivolts. Yes or no? My output has to be 100 millivolts. Is this okay or not? I have assumed that my IS, reverse saturation current flowing through the diode is, normally it is very small. Okay? So, 10 to the power of minus 16 amperes. Can you neglect 10 to the power minus 16 amperes or not? VBE is equal to 10 millivolts, my input signal coming from mic, and you are intended to get some gain, a very nominal gain of 10 only, 10. You want your input signal to get multiplied with 10, okay? Then what should be your output voltage is going to be? Your output voltage is going to be input into gain, that is 100 millivolts, okay? For your output to be 100 millivolts, okay, what should be the RL is? For your output to be 100 millivolts, what should be your RL is? Okay, can you find out? My V naught is equal to minus IC into RL. Okay, what is my RL is? My RL is given as, okay, my RL is given as V naught by IC. Okay, V naught by IC. What is my V naught is? V naught is 100 millivolts. Substitute V naught is equal to 100 millivolts. Substitute IC is equal to, what is IC is equal to, you know, IS into e power VBE by VT. You take VT as 26 millivolts. Okay?
26.
You take VT as 26 millivolts. Tell me what is the value of RL. Okay, take IC as IS into e power VBE by VT. VBE is 10 millivolts, VT is 26 millivolts. Millivolts, millivolts gets cancelled. So, 10 by 26. Okay, so tell me what is RL is. Tell me what is RL is. V naught is 100 millivolts, IC is IS into, that is 10 to the power of minus 16 into e power VBE by VT. VBE is 10 millivolts. VT is 26 millivolts. So, millivolts, millivolts gets cancelled. So, e power 10 by 26. Okay? So, tell me what it is. What? 10 by 26. So, now tell me what is your value. What is e power 10 by 26 value? How much is RL?
Minus 0.68 into 10 power 17.
Okay. Don't worry about the minus sign. Okay. Gain always I'll take it as magnitude. Okay. So you will not get minus sign. So what is that you are getting? 10 to the power of 16, 17 kilo, 17 ohms. Is that RL value is available in practice? 10 to the power of 16, 17 ohms resistance. Is it available in practice? Is it practically possible?
No, sir.
No, so that is the problem, okay? So, if you directly apply the input signal, you are required to have a load, okay, with such a value of resistance. In practice, you will not find any load means what? Load can be your fan, light, your AC, whatsoever it is, okay? So, there will not be any load that is available which will be having such a huge resistance, okay? Such a huge resistance means what? It doesn't take any current at all. It draws no current at all. Will there be any load such that it draws no current, no power consumption, no electricity bill? If no load is drawing no current, no electricity bill. Okay, free of cost everything. But there will not be any such load which will not be taking or drawing any amount of current. Okay, so in practice we will be finding RL in terms of kilo ohms. That means it draws enough amount of current. Okay, so this way is practically impossible. If I try to apply the input signal directly to my transistor, okay, my amplification will not happen. Okay, my amplification will not happen because if my amplification has to happen, I need to have an RL in such a way that it draws nothing. And in practice, you find no load that is not going to draw any amount of current. Okay. In practice, you will be finding no load that is not going to draw any amount of current. okay, right? So that is why instead of applying directly, you will be applying. Is my point is okay? Why your transistor is not able to amplify when you directly give your AC signal to be amplified to it? Okay,
right.
So now let us see what actually we have to do is we have to apply the input signal on top of DC signal. Okay, we have to apply the input signal on top of DC signal. Okay, we have to apply the input signal, okay, on top of DC signal. Is this okay? The diagram. This is RL. Okay. Let us say that this is 750 millivolts. Okay. This is your VBE. Okay. This is your VBE. Again, your collector current is this. Okay. Right. Now, what is going to happen? Now, what is going to happen? Understand carefully, everyone. Suppose if signal is not there, okay, suppose if signal is not there, how much is the voltage that is applied between base and the emitter? How much is the voltage that is applied between base and the emitter? If signal is not there, how much is the voltage you are applying? DC voltage, let us say that is 750 millivolts, okay, 750 millivolts. How much is the current that is flowing? 1.7 milliamperes, okay. Suppose if your signal is coming, okay, suppose if you are adding to this DC signal 750 millivolts, you are adding your AC signal. AC signal is 10 millivolts. That means what is your total signal in between base and the emitter now? Your total signal in between base and the emitter is both AC plus DC. How much is that? This is 10 and this is 750. How much is that? 760 millivolts. Okay, so the change in your input signal is 10 millivolts. Yes or no? Earlier it is 750. Now, because your signal has come, it has got become equal to 760. So, what is the change in your input signal? Your change in your input signal is 10 millivolts. For a change in your input signal 10 millivolts, how much is the change in your collector current you observe here? Tell me, what is the change in your collector current? When your input signal is 760 millivolts, your current is 2.48 milliamperes. So, for a change in 10 millivolts, okay, for a change in 10 millivolts, what is the change in the current? How much?
0.78.
What do you say? Does it milliamperes or microamperes?
Milliamperes.
Very good. 0.78 milliamperes. Okay. Now you find out what should be your RL such that for a change in your input of 10 millivolts, okay, you require a change in your collector current of 0.78 milliamperes. Okay. For a change in your input, 10 millivolts. What is your gain you want? The gain you want is 10. Okay. For a change in your input 10 millivolts, if your gain wants to be 10, what should be your output is? 100 millivolts. So, for your output 100 millivolts, okay, what should be your RL? If your change in your IC is 0.78 milliamperes. Okay. 0.78 milliamperes. So, how much is your RL is? RL is equal to, okay, RL is equal to V naught is 100 millivolts divided by change in the IC that you require for a change in your 10 millivolts input signal for which your output is going to be 100 millivolts is given by how much? 0.78 milliamperes. So, how much is your RL you require?
128.2.
128 ohms roughly. Okay. Is it not 128 ohms? Yes or no?
Yeah.
Okay. Now it is practicable. Okay. It is practicable. Very less resistance. Okay. Offers more amount of current. That is what is the scenario in practice. In practice, all varieties of loads are going to draw as much amount of current as possible from the available source. This is practicable. Okay. Right. So if you apply your AC signal on top of DC, then your transistor is going to amplify your AC input signal. Okay. Did you get my point? When you are applying your AC on top of DC, then your transistor is able to amplify, okay, your AC signal. Right. Okay. So this way of providing the required DC voltages and currents, okay, is what is called as biasing. Okay, this way of providing this appropriate DC voltages and currents is what is called as biasing. Okay, right? What do you mean by biasing? Providing DC voltages, providing required voltages and currents using external sources to establish operating point in active region. So that what is going to happen? Your transistor acts as an amplifier. Okay. Is the biasing is okay? What do you mean by biasing? Providing required voltages and currents using external sources. Okay, you have to give externally whatever the required voltage sources or current sources to establish an operating point. Q point means operating point in active region, so that your transistor acts as an amplifier. What do you mean by operating point? You know already what is mean by operating point. VCE comma IC. Okay, have you remembered what is operating point? VCE comma IC. Okay. Are you going to fix this VCE comma IC when there is no signal or when there is a signal?
When there is no signal,
you are fixing some value of your VCE and IC. When the signal comes, this VCE or VBE, whatever you have applied, is going to change, okay, by several orders in your collector current, and that large amount of collector current is going to flow through your RL. There you will be getting your voltage to be increased. Okay, I repeat again that when you are applying your voltages, bias voltages and currents, when there is no signal, okay, when the signal comes, okay, due to the changes in the voltage, it can effectively change your collector current by several orders, because IC is exponentially related to your VB. Even if input is varying by very small amount, your collector current changes by very larger amount. This large amount of change in the collector current is going to flow through your RL, and thereby you will be getting a larger amount of voltage across the RL. Okay, so this is how amplification process is going to take place. Okay, right? Okay. You are given a task of biasing the transistor, okay? And what you have to take care is, you have to ensure that your IE is maintained at 1 milliampere, VCE is maintained at 5 volts, you have to take power supply of 10 volts, okay? And alpha is equal to 0.995 is what is given, okay? How do you proceed? Are asked to bias the transistor. Okay, so how do you proceed? Question note chesara?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Idhar calculator unnaya? Mee sondanga cheyakandi, calculator use cheyandi. Okay na? IE is equal to IS by alpha into e power VBE by VT. Okay, now IE is 1 milliampere, IS is 9.95 into 10 power minus 13 divided by alpha is 0.0995. Okay, this goes with 10 times here. Okay, so 10 into 10 power minus 13 is 10 power minus 12 into e power VBE by VT. Okay, so bring this 10 to the power of minus 12 here. Okay, so 10 to the power of minus 3 by 10 to the power of minus 12 is equal to e power VBE by VT. Okay, right. So when this 10 to the power of minus 12 goes to the numerator, what happens?
10 power 9.
10 power
9.
10 power 9. 10 power 9 is equal to e power VBE by VT. Okay, na? Take natural logarithm on both sides. What happens? VBE by VT is equal to, take natural logarithm on both sides. What is the natural logarithm of this? Ln of 10 to the power of 9 weyandi. ఎంత వచ్చిందో చెప్పండి.
20.72.
ఇంకేమైనా ఉన్నాయా అక్కడ? ఇంకేమైనా ఉన్నాయా? 20.72 ఇంటూ 26 మిల్లీ వోల్ట్స్ ఇస్ వాట్ ఈస్ యువర్ విబిఈస్
టోటల్
538.72.
విబిఈ ఇస్ ఈక్వల్ టు 538.72 మిల్లీ వోల్ట్స్. మిల్లీ వోల్ట్సేనా?
ఎస్ సార్.
ఎస్ సార్.
ఓకే. So 538.72 millivolts you need to apply as your input signal VBE so that it will be taking care that your IE is equal to 1 milliampere. Is this point is okay? You are asked to fix your IE, okay, which is given as 1 milliampere. In order to fix IE is equal to 1 milliampere, you have to apply externally yourself a VBE is equal to 0.538 volts or 538.72 millivolts. Either way, it is same. 0.538 volts, you apply chayali in between base and the emitter so that IE is going to be 1 milliampere. Okay, IE is going to be 1 milliampere. Is this point is okay? Yes or no? In between base and the emitter, how much is the voltage you have to apply externally? 0.538 volts so that IE is going to be 1 milliampere. Is the point is okay?
Yes sir.
Okay. If you know IE, can you find out IC? If you know IE, can you find out IC? If you know IE, can you find out IC? IC is equal to alpha times IE.
Alpha times.
What is IC is? Alpha is 0.995 into 1 milliampere is milliampere. Okay? Yes or no? Yes or no? So my circuit is like this. Okay? My circuit is like this. This is my RC. This is my 10 volts. How much is VCC I have to take? 10 volts. Okay. How much is the collector current I have? 0.995 milliamperes. Okay. How do I fix my IC now? How do I fix my IC? How do I fix my IC? How do I fix my IC? IC is given by VCC minus. From here to here, how much is given? From here to here, how much is given that we have to fix? In the question, from VCE,
5 volts.
So, VCC minus VCE by RC. Okay? Do you know IC? What you want to fix? You know IC. Okay? Do you know VCE? What you want to fix? You know, which is 5 volts. Is VCC is given in the question? Yes, it is given. How do you fix your IC? Choose an appropriate value of RC that will be taking care of fixing your IC. Okay? VBE is going to take care of allowing your current, desired IE that you flow in your circuit. Okay? Whatever the voltage that you apply here, 0.538 volts. Okay? That will take care of the desired emitter current to flow in your circuit. Whatever the RC value you choose, what is my RC value? You tell me 10 minus 5 by IC is 0.995 kilo ohms. How much is my RC value?
5
kilo ohms. Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, okay. Sir.
So RC is equal to 5 kilo ohms is going to take care of the amount of current IC is equal to 0.995 milliamperes flowing in your circuit. Okay, RC is going to take care of. You want your VC to be fixed at 5 volts. You have chosen your VCC to be 10 volts. So VCC minus VCE by IC is what is going to be given your RC is. So RC is going to take care of fixing your IC. VBE is going to take care of fixing your IE. Okay, this is how you are. Yes.
5.025.
Okay. Approximately, I have written. Okay. So did you understand the problem? Okay. Understand the problem very carefully. The problem that is given to us is fixing the emitter current and the VCE. VCE is 5 volts is given for us to fix. IE is equal to 1 milliampere is given for us to fix. With the help of the known equation, IE is equal to IS by alpha into e power VB by VT, I found out what should be the desired VBE in order to maintain IE is equal to 1 milliampere, and I found out to be 0.538 volts. If I apply voltage between base and the emitter at 0.538 volts, it takes care of allowing a current, emitter current of 1 milliampere to flow in the circuit. With I is equal to 1 milliampere and alpha is equal to 0.995, IC I find out to be 0.995 milliamperes. If I want to fix this IC, I need to choose this RC value such that it is 5 kilo ohms approximately, so that it will take care of fixing your IC. Is the way of biasing the given transistor is okay? Biasing means what? Fixing your VCE 5 volts and IC, whatever that is being given, fixing is nothing but your biasing. Is this problem is okay? Everyone?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So, we have done first problem. Please do understand this. And after this class again, once again, you revisit this problem. And we will continue from this from tomorrow onwards. Okay. But the basis for tomorrow's class is this particular problem only. I will be asking in the next class what are the drawbacks of this particular problem. Okay. Right. So, revisit this problem once again and try to understand what exactly is the problem is, how we proceeded in fixing the problem. Okay, right. So I'll be stopping here. I'll take the attendance. Those who have responded, they can leave the meeting. Okay.